you'll see, first thing I do is get the tail up, and we run on the main wheels as we accelerate, and then she starts to want to fly, so we let her. So a very short takeoff. It was built in 1943.
Okay.
And it was used to train pilots during the war, and then it was bought by somebody, taken to France, and I think it was used as a glider tug in France.
Okay.
Towing gliders, and then eventually somebody bought it back to England and restored it back to its original World War II colour scheme. So we can give them a wave as we go over.
Fantastic.
Are you enjoying it so far?
Absolutely fantastic. I love it. Just what I hope for.
Right, they're watching us. Give them a big wave. Now I can put on the power again and we can start climbing. Oh, it's just lovely poodling around on a summer's afternoon.
So are we coming up this junction 10 we're coming up?
Yeah, so we're coming up to junction 10 here. I'll just come right a little bit. That will put Winnersh on the left, won't it?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Well, my house is just where that new building is, past there.
Oh, okay.
We're quite close to the motorway.
If we follow the motorway around a little bit, we'll keep it on the right.
Yeah, yeah.
I think this isn't much higher than the airfield.
That's where we are, just down here on the right. Right next to the railway line.
Oh, okay.
And I can actually see our house. That's fantastic. Fantastic.
And the other rule is you have to be able to land clear if the engine should stop. So we've got those fields behind the wingtip. We'd make those no problem at all if we had to.
That's incredible.
I'll come round again.
Down there. Absolutely incredible.
Okay, your turn to fly the aeroplane now.
Okay.
So take a light grip on the stick.
Yep.
We're going to start heading towards Henley. Now the first thing to do is look ahead of you.
Yep.
And see where the horizon is.
Yes.
You see it's just above the cowling.
Yes.
Well that's where we want it to be when we're flying straight and level.
Okay.
Now if you move the stick gently forward, you'll see the nose goes down.
Yep.
Move the stick gently back and the nose comes up.
Yeah.
See, it's quite sensitive, isn't it?
It is very sensitive.
So if the nose is up like that, just ease it forward until the horizon comes, until the nose goes below the horizon.
Okay.
So ease it forward a little bit more so that you can see the horizon above the cowling.
Got you.
Because if we keep the nose too high, you slow down.
Yeah.
We which we don't really want to do. Now, if we want to make a turn,
yep.
we move the stick in the direction that we want to turn.
Yep.
So if we want to turn right, move the stick to the right, and the aeroplane banks, and it'll keep on turning
until you come back.
Until you move it in the opposite direction to roll the wings level. And when you roll the wings level, just check where the nose is relative to the horizon.
Yeah.
Because you always want to bring it back to that straight and level attitude.
Okay.
Okay, you have control now.
Right.
Do you see the mirror?
I can, yep.
Woohoo! Okay, let's make a turn to the... Oh, there's a helicopter on our left. Let's make a turn to the left. We'll get behind the helicopter. So stick to the left. That's it. A little bit more. Nice and positive. That's it. And then roll the wings level. Perfect. So we'll let him go by. Okay, let's make a turn to the right now. So nice angle of bank, a little bit more, steepen it up a little bit, that's better, that's it. And then keep an eye on the nose, and just keep the nose tracking on the horizon. But the nose still goes up and down with the movement of the stick. Okay, and then reverse that straight into a left turn. Very nice.
Very sensitive.
Yeah, well, what I say is you only need to move the stick as far as you move the handlebars when you're riding a bike.
Yeah.
So it doesn't need a lot of movement. Okay, roll the wings level there. Lower the nose slightly to get it below the horizon. And we've got Henley over to our right. In the sort of 2 o'clock position.
Oh yeah.
And we'll fly towards Henley a little way. That's it. You happy to stay in control?
Yes, I am. Yeah,
okay,
I'm enjoying
it. You have it. Right. How's your navigation?
If you test me, I'll give it my best.
Well, can you tell me where the airfield is?
Yeah, I wouldn't guess. It's over there.
Yeah, that's very good actually. Not many people can tell. If you look out along the right wing and just behind the wing, can you see the green field?
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah, all the fields around it have turned brown, so yeah. It's a bit easier to spot now than it used to be.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's turn right and head back towards the airfield. I'll let you fly the aeroplane all the way. I'm going to take it.
Except the last bit, maybe.
I'm going to take a little bit of power off now, and we'll let the height drop down. So, see the airfield coming around now. So keep it in our 1 o'clock. So,
yeah.
So we don't want to go directly to it. We want to keep it on the right of the nose.
Okay.
And we're going to just drift down. So let the nose drop a little bit. As you take the power off, the nose will drop naturally. I'll give them a call and tell them we're heading back.
Okay.
I'm going to just feed in a little bit of power now to arrest that descent. So you can bring the nose back up to the horizon again. Just below the horizon. That's very nice. Good. Right, well I'll nod off now and you can take us home.
If only, eh?
So when we're approaching the airfield, we just keep a good lookout because chances are there might be somebody else arriving at the same time, somebody else coming back. Okay, start turning right now. So there's another aircraft on final. He's stopping, so that's all right. Golf X-ray Victor overhead. I'm going to take the power off and we're going to start descending. I want you to keep turning right in the descent.
Okay.
That's it. So let the nose come down and keep turning all the way round. Golf X-ray Victor, descending dead side, 2-9. So just raise the nose a little bit now. Keep that turn going. Raise the nose a little bit more, we're a bit low. That's it. So is he? Okay, roll the wings level there. Good. Keep the nose above the horizon. That's good. Can't see any other aircraft ahead of us. Okay, so lower the nose a little bit now. And let's turn right. So we're going parallel to the runway. That's it, a little bit of back pressure. Okay, level the wings there. Okay, I have control.
Okay. Fabulous, fabulous.
So we fly a nice curved approach, because I can't see much ahead. By flying a curved approach like this, we can see the runway all the way down. So we check the windsock, the wind's straight down the runway, so we can make a three-point landing. If we had a crosswind, we'd have to use a different technique. Very slight crosswind from the right.
Yep.
So I'll just angle it into the wind a little bit. X-ray Victor, final to land. And as we get closer to the ground, just start to raise the nose. If I get it right, we touch down on two wheels and the tail skid at the same time.
Fantastic. That was tremendous.